Hey there, this is sort of my catch-all video for strumming. I know that sounds like a really basic thing, but a lot of people have questions about it, so hopefully this video will answer them all. Okay, so strumming is basic. It's as simple as it gets. You just strum the strings. Now, it's all in the wrist. A lot of people strum by locking their wrist and then bending their arm at the elbow. Now, there's two problems with this method. First, you're going to get really tired really fast. Second, watch where I end up picking each string when I strum like that. I end up picking the low strings over about here, and then I pick the high strings way up here by the bridge. Now go ahead and pick the high E string right here in the middle, like where the sound hole would be on an acoustic guitar. Sounds nice there. Now pick it real close to the bridge. It's harsh, tinny, just generally unpleasant. So what you want to do is use your wrist to make sure that when you strum, you go in a straight line, like perfectly perpendicular to the strings, straight across. That's how you're going to get the best sound. So now that you got the motion down, we're going to start working on our rhythm. Grab your metronome, and if you don't have one, shame on you, go get one now. Set it at a nice moderate tempo and just play downstrokes for every click, and just count 1, 2, 3, 4 as you play. Like this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1. It's easy. Once you got that down, start adding upstrokes in between each of the downstrokes. So you'll do down up on every click. Whenever you play an upstroke, count it and. So like this.
1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and.
That's easy too. If you're having trouble with that, go ahead and slow it down to half that speed and play a downstroke and then an upstroke for each click, like this.
1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and.
It's pretty simple. So now we're going to spice things up a bit. All we're really doing is dropping random notes out of our 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and pattern that we were just doing. So let's try 1, 2 and 3 and 4 and. Down, down, up, down, up, down, up. It goes like this.
1, 2 and 3 and 4 and 1, 2 and 3 and 4 and 1.
Yeah, that one's pretty easy. One that's really common that some people have a bit of trouble with is down, down, up, up, down, up. Counted 1, 2 and 4 and. Goes like this.
1, 2 and 4 and 1, 2 and 4 and.
That one is really common. You'll hear that in tons and tons of songs. I'm just going to play it a little bit faster so you can kind of get the idea. You'll go, oh yeah, I've heard that one plenty of times. Sounds like this. So once you got that one, you're probably set to go. But I've got one more that I really want to show you. This one isn't as common, but it's very good practice. It goes down, up, down, down. That's it. Counted 1, skip 2, and 3, 4. 1 and 3, 4. 1 and 3, 4. Watch my hand while I do this. It's never going to stop moving. Okay?
1 and 3, 4. 1 and 3, 4. 1 and 3, 4. 1 and 3, 4.
So, you might be asking, well, why don't you just go down, up, down, down? Why do you keep moving in the middle? Well, the reason is because that just helps you keep better rhythm, better time. It gives you a better feel. If I do it like this, it might get a little sloppy, but if I keep my hand moving to the beat the whole time, then it's always nice and tight, and it's a nice feel. There you go. So it's also worth mentioning right now that strum patterns are primarily a teaching tool, not a compositional one. People don't sit down writing a song thinking, okay, well, the verse is going to have this strum pattern, and then the chorus is going to have this strum pattern. No, they don't do that. These are songs, and songs are all about the melody. And whatever rhythm you're playing those chords to should reflect the melody. It should follow the movement and rhythm of the melody. I'm also going to put this out there, and this is a little weird, but I've gotten this from more than one person, so I just want to make sure nobody thinks this. There's no master index of strum patterns where they're all laid out and numbered. That's just ridiculous. I don't know where people get this idea from, but it is out there. Any numbering system you see where it's like, well, here's strum pattern one, here's strum pattern two, strum pattern three. That's just for that book or that video or that worksheet or that website or whatever. There's no universal list where every strum pattern ever has been collected and categorized and numbered. That's stupid.